I've been playing video games my whole life, where the bot that you're playing against is either incredibly hard or incredibly easy, depending on how good a gamer you are. But this seems to be an extension of that. Have I got that right, Mika?
Yeah, absolutely. So that is a racing agent that was trained to really be competitive with the best esports drivers in Gran Turismo, which is this extremely highly realistic racing game. And we did that last year, published on a cover of Nature. And this year, actually this month, we released it into the game in varying levels of difficulty. So if you're a beginner, if you're intermediate, or if you're an expert, you can drive against the agent. But we balance the performance of the car, so you do have a chance against the agent in beginner mode. But you can also race against it. 1v1, full head, you know, same cars against a fully blown superhuman racing agent that we released last year. And so we hope this really can inspire people to learn from the agent. And it's an important step for the game because, right, you know, if you are an expert in the game, it will take some time for you. And you need friends actually at the same level to compete against. And that's what the agent actually addresses.
Mika, a few weeks ago, we had Sonia Huang, who's a partner at VC firm Sequoia, on the show, and she has this thesis that by 2030, generative AI tools will be so good that they will be used to just dream up video games. And I wondered, what big picture work is Sony doing to that effect in the video game space?
So obviously, I mean, gaming has always been technology driven, right? And so we are looking at new technologies. Obviously, there's been a lot of buzz around ChatGPT, Midjourney, and these kinds of models. For us, it's really important that this technology is there for the creator. So we are interested in what this does to gaming creators, how it helps them create fulfill their creative visions. And so, you know, people are starting to take up the technology. I think there's a lot of things that still need to happen in the technology as well for this to be really useful for gaming. But we do see also, you know, people already starting using it, the artists are using it. And that's really important for us because for us, really, the creator, so we are a creator-centric company, is really about what the creators are doing with this technology.
Delve in there, Mika. What more needs to be done to the technology to make it really purposeful, really useful for Sony?
Yeah, so obviously what we see today is a lot around 2D image generation, but, you know, games are 3D. I mean, that's just a very big one. And obviously that's something that would need to be addressed for this to be really impactful on the gaming production pipeline. But again, you know, I think the technology develops extremely fast. GT Sophy was a Nature paper last year. It's in the game now. So, you know, the cycles from like high-level technology breakthroughs to actually bringing this to users or creators around the world is very, very fast. One thing I would say, though, is what is really important for us is really the ethical aspects of this, right? So we need to make sure also that this technology is developed in a responsible way. Yes. From the data that goes into it, it needs to be fair and transparent. You know, people have rights, creators have rights. These need to be respected. It's also important what happens on the output side. And so for us, actually, AI ethics is at the core. For Sony AI, we have this, we have a dedicated team looking at all the projects we're doing from an AI ethics perspective and really shaping how we develop the technology.
Do you need to be hand in hand with governments around this? We just had the SEC chair on talking about AI's use within finance, and he's wanting to perhaps see some rules of the road in place. Do you need governments to work alongside to build this ethical roadmap?
I think it's important for governments to play a role, but I think this is also beyond governments. From a Sony perspective, we have a responsibility for our creators. We have, you know, we work with them on a day-to-day basis, you know, in many ways they're part of the company, actually. And for us, it's not just about government regulation. For us, it's really about making this technology for the creators so that they can unleash their creativity and their imagination. And so the human for us is really central. Right. And yeah, of course, governments, you know, play a role in this, but it's also companies that have to step up.
Hey, Mika, Caroline and I are having a lot of executives from the world of AI on at the moment, a lot of investors, a lot of academics. What we're struggling to understand is how can we know how competent Sony AI is at its craft? What makes you different? What makes you stand out from all those other AI players out there?
I would say two things. One is we have extremely high impact projects and we aim also for, you know, technology contributions that really are recognized. For instance, the GT Sophy agent was featured on the cover of Nature, and that's really an important part of us to raise awareness about the technology, but also show that we are actually able to do that. The other thing is really, as part of Sony, as I mentioned, for us it's important that we focus on the people. and how people use this technology going forward to, you know, fulfill their creative visions. And I think that kind of sets us apart. And, you know, our voice, I think, should be heard in this space.